Hi, this is Mike with SonicDriveMedia. Today we're going to be talking about Native Instruments Massive and just this amp section right here on the synth. Be sure to check out our website, SonicDriveMedia.com, for all types of other tutorials, preset packs. We have a promotion where we're giving away some free presets right now. All right, so let's get started. So if you were just to hit new sound on this, we're really, this video, I'm just going to talk about this one small section, so there's not much to it. Basically, if we look at our routing tab, we have oscillators, which is this whole side, our noise generators and whatnot. Those are all coming through our filters, and we can have inserted effects on those and whatnot. But then we run into our amp right here. Now, we can adjust the amp and whatnot there, but it's still going to be routed through our effects and our EQ until it finally comes out and we hear what we're hearing. The main things about the amp are that we have an envelope. When we hit the new sound, automatically envelope 4 is assigned to this. And just really quickly about envelopes, I have another video on envelopes, but we have attack, decay, sustain, and release. So if I were to have, I'm just gonna tap on this, the longer I make the decay, or I mean the attack, it kind of takes a while for the sound to kind of come up, right? Or for the volume to come up. If I have it, just as soon as I tap on it. The decay is a short thing that depends on, it shows how long from that initial attack till it starts to sustain. And the sustain is just the level. It might be loud when I tap it. But it, as I hold down the key, it's just not ringing out anymore. So I'm holding down the key. Alright, so the level on this, they're calling it level, but it's sustain in other keyboards. And then your release would be, I'm just going to tap the key. With the release really high, it just keeps ringing out, and I can just tap it once and it'll just keep ringing all day. The other thing this amp does is it has the pan feature, so I could have things coming left, right on the synth. Just what I'm hearing out of there. Common thing to do this is just run an LFO on it and it'll, you know, go left to right. That's pretty much it on the amp. So nice short sweet video. There it is. So once again, be sure to check out our website, SonicDriveMedia.com. We have all types of other tutorials, presets. We're giving away some free presets right now. And if you're watching this on YouTube, feel free to hit the like, subscribe buttons, leave a comment, and I'll catch you on the next video. Thanks a lot.